is, yeah, I just want to get some sort of video out for you guys, even if it's just kind of like a whispering, rambling, random video. So, there's always noises outside our windows. Like, you would think that our windows would be more insulated because we live in the middle of New York City, but no. I was joking with my roommate the other night, because we heard a siren sound that we had never heard before, and I was like, it seems like every day there's a new siren sound that I learned in New York City, and it's totally true. All the time I'll be like, I've never heard that noise before. So I don't know if you've ever lived in New York City or been to New York City, you know what I mean. So yeah, I thought I would just kind of ramble and talk to you guys in like a whispering voice, because that can be relaxing for some people. And then towards the second half of the video, I have like a couple items that I'm going to make some noises with, so there will be like crinkling, some tapping, some book noises or like paper sounds, and also showing you guys a lipstick that I bought at Sephora the other day. But yeah, so I thought in the first half I would just kind of talk about being in New York, getting settled in, and talk about some classes and, you know, things like that. So as most of you know, I think I am in New York City, whereas before I was in the San Francisco area in California. So came all the way from the West Coast, and this is my first time coming to New York, you know, being aware that I was in New York. I believe we came to New York when I was maybe like 3, but I don't remember it at all. The only thing I really remember is, oh my god, these cars are so loud. The only thing I remember really is, I think, and I don't even know if it's a real memory, if it's just something I made up, but it's like, it was at night, and we were on a ferry, and I just remember seeing the entire New York skyline, and that's kind of the only thing I remember. So, of course, that was when the Twin Towers were still there, because that was probably in like 1997, 1998. And yeah, actually today is 9/11, so my roommates and I, once they all come back from doing their thing, we are going to probably go to the Freedom Tower, you know, where the waterfall is, where all the memorial stuff is happening, and probably just kind of go and pay our respects and things like that. One of my roommates is a native New Yorker, and obviously on the day she was in New York, but she doesn't really remember it because she was probably like 6 at the time. I don't remember it either. I don't remember where I was. I don't remember seeing it. I don't even remember hearing about it until like 2 years later. Obviously, I know I heard about it on the day, but you know what I mean? Like, I don't remember anything about it. But anyways, yeah, so that's probably what we're gonna do today. Okay, so I got to New York about 2 weeks ago. It'll be 2 weeks tomorrow. And it's an amazing city. I feel like some native New Yorkers might be like, well, you're just saying that because, like, you know, you've never been in a city, or like, you don't know yet, you know. But it's like, I do. Like, I lived in Beijing for many years of my life, and Beijing, trust me, has way worse traffic than any single big city I've ever been to, including New York. So, you know, I realize that a lot of it is the novelty of being in a new city, but I just, that's what I love. I love being in a big city with everything that comes with it. Do I think I'll live, you know, in a big city forever? No, of course not. You know, when I have kids and settle down, I would love to live in a suburb because that's how I grew up, and I think that's more the type of family environment that I would want to be in. But as of now, like being a young 21-year-old, I love being in big cities. There's always something to do. You know, although I complain about the noise outside, it's kind of nice almost. It's kind of like, you know, there's always people around you, whereas like in the suburbs, sometimes it can get so quiet that it's eerie and it's weird. So I really do enjoy, you know, the noises and the people and just all the different interesting people you meet on a daily basis. The fact that, like, there's so many possible connections that you could make with people in the street, people in the restaurants, things like that. There's just, like, a lot more chance for human connection, I feel, versus you know, living in suburbs where it's all houses and houses, and you know, obviously you're not gonna go around and knock on people's houses and say hi and stuff, but here it's like, you know, someone on the street will say, oh, I like your hair, and I'll be like, thanks, I like your dress, and it's like, you can, it's easier to kind of make that connection, if you know what I mean. So I've always been a big city type girl. Versus, like, I feel like a closed campus. I don't know why that, I think it makes question down below, and I can try, you know, maybe to film a video like that for you guys. Don't know if that'll be interesting or not. I'm just gonna drink a little bit of my milk tea. And this is from Coco. I actually, the first time I had Coco was in Beijing, and that's really mainly the brand that I drink in Beijing. But back home in California, we have a lot more smaller milk tea chains, like local, and I like going to those a little bit more because I think they taste better, to be honest. But here in New York, I don't think milk tea is a huge thing, so I just go to Coco because I kind of know about it and I know what I like from it. pain medication. class the next week or like things that we have to read. Too. I don't always have time to like get back to you guys in comments and stuff, and then when